Earlier this year, the U.S. Navy confirmed that destroyers escorting the supercarrier, USS Gerald R. Ford, would be equipped with Raytheon Coyote and/or Anduril Roadrunner-M counter-drone systems. A newly released photo of the Arleigh Burke-class destroyer, USS Bainbridge, shows the new launchers for Coyote interceptors installed on its deck. The Navy released the photo of USS Bainbridge, showing the ship sailing in the Ionian Sea between Italy and Greece. Bainbridge is one of three Arleigh Burke-class destroyers assigned to the Gerald R. Ford Carrier Strike Group, alongside USS Winston S. Churchill and USS Mitscher. The new counter-drone interceptor launchers are mounted on the port side of Bainbridge's aft superstructure, just forward of the ship's rear Mark 41 vertical launch system array. The same launcher is also installed aboard USS Winston S. Churchill. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Coyote will reinforce anti-drone capabilities of U.S. Navy destroyers. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Uncrewed aerial systems, UAS, or drones, have evolved far beyond hobbyist gadgets or simple surveillance tools. They are now being used as weapons capable of striking targets from long standoff ranges. Advances in drone technology have made them both highly capable and relatively inexpensive. From the battles in Syria and Nagorno-Karabakh to the ongoing war in Ukraine as well as recent Indo-Pak conflict, drones have proven to be key assets. The growing reality is that a swarm of armed drones can inflict significant damage. From late 2023 to mid-2025, the U.S. Navy endured one of its most intense maritime confrontations in years, as Houthi militants used drones and missiles to test American naval dominance. In November 2024, Houthi forces launched at least 8 one-way attack drones, 5 anti-ship ballistic missiles, and 3 anti-ship cruise missiles at U.S. destroyers in the Bab el-Mandeb Strait. All were intercepted, but the attack foreshadowed a sustained campaign to come. On December 16th, USS Kearney shot down 14 Houthi drones in the Red Sea, again without casualties or damage. In response, the Navy deployed roughly 30 warships, spent $1.5 billion on munitions, and organized a multinational task force to safeguard shipping lanes. It was evident that even a non-state actor like Houthis armed with drones could create problems for the U.S. Navy. While no U.S. ship was damaged, the growing threat of drones has forced the U.S. Navy to redesign its response strategies. As per manufacturer Raytheon, Coyote Kinetic Effector is a low-cost, rail-launched missile variant with a boost rocket motor and a turbine engine for high-speed counter-unmanned aircraft system missions. The complete system consists of mainly 3 components. 1. Four-tube launcher that can be installed in both mobile and stationary configuration. 2. Raytheon's own Ku-band radio frequency system, or KRFS. This fire control radar will cue Coyote to intercept their targets. 3. A generator to provide the necessary power. Coyote weighs about 13 pounds or 5.9 kilograms. It can be launched by firing like a traditional missile from a launch tube. So Coyote could be launched from air, sea, and land. Once it leaves the launcher, the drone deploys its 6-foot-wide main wing, rear stabilizer, and tail fins. The operator can now issue commands to control and direct it. The Ku-band radio frequency system is a 360-degree radar that senses incoming drones, rockets, artillery, and mortars. It can detect Class 1 UAS out to 10 miles, 16 kilometers, and can even detect objects as small as a 9mm bullet. Coyote has multiple variants, Block 2 and its subtypes, and Block 3. The Coyote 2 is a kinetic interceptor, whereas the Coyote 3 operates as a non-kinetic interceptor and carries unspecified payloads, which is likely to include electronic warfare systems or high-power RF pulse emitter. Unlike its expendable counterpart, Raytheon claims that the non-kinetic variant can be recovered, refurbished, and reused without leaving the battlefield. The speed, range, and endurance depend on the variants. For example, Coyote 2C has a speed of 370 miles per hour, 595 kilometers per hour, a range of 130 kilometers or 80 miles per hour, and an endurance of about 2 hours depending on the variant. According to Raytheon, multiple Coyotes might be able to defeat drone swarms too. The company could load it with software that it developed as part of the U.S. Navy's low-cost UAV swarming technology effort, or LOCUST, which lets them operate as a group. Viewers may note that LOCUST-enabled UAVs can share information and coordinate their actions without constant human intervention. The U.S. Army has been operating the Coyote Block 2 for years as part of its Low, Slow, Unmanned Aircraft Integrated Defeat System LIDS, available in both mobile and fixed-site configurations. LIDS has been deployed to the Middle East, Africa, and Europe, and has seen combat use in at least some of those regions. Cheap drones are becoming the weapon of choice for many military forces because of their cost effectiveness. In response to the rise in drone attacks on U.S. military bases in Iraq and Syria, along with Houthi assaults in the Red Sea, the U.S. military has intensified its efforts to procure and deploy anti-drone defense systems. Coyote's deployment on U.S. Navy destroyer is part of this larger effort. Coyote is the first and, so far, only dedicated hard-kill counter-UAS system installed on a warship. Unlike traditional surface-to-air missiles, the Coyote interceptor is not only more affordable, but also has loitering capability, allowing it to remain airborne and be dynamically redirected against incoming uncrewed threats. It is capable enough to take out fast, maneuverable drones like Shahed 238. A single Block 2 Coyote costs roughly $100,000, whereas an SM-2 Block 3C, one of the primary air defense missiles used on the Navy's Arleigh Burke-class destroyers, averages about $2 million per round. Coyote gives crews the ability to retask the system in real time as the threat picture changes, or even launch it preemptively against potential targets. Such flexibility is something standard surface-to-air missiles lack. Coyote's capabilities are especially valuable for warships, which face strict limits on magazine capacity and have little ability to reload at sea. It is likely that more U.S. Navy warships will be armed with this system.